Hello everyone, today we are going to see about circuit analysis. We will see the introduction. Basic of a circuit analysis, we can see simply an electric circuit. What do you mean by electric circuit? It is an interconnection of some electrical components or electrical elements. Here I have given some example. It's basic circuit which is having one battery and one lamp. So we can tell this as an electric circuit. I have given 6 basic SI units and 1 derived units which will be used in electric circuit analysis. These things you might have studied in your school days, like length, mass, time. This quantity and all measured on this basic unit, like length will be measured with meter, similarly mass kilogram, time will be measured under the second, current is ampere, temperature will be defined on Kelvin, intensity, light luminous intensity will be having the unit of candela, and the charge will be having coulomb. This is a symbol of this same basic unit. Look at here the units symbols which has been mentioned in capital letter is mentioning the name of the scientist who invented this quantity. Other meter, kilogram and all, just it's a basic unit, but this ampere, Kelvin and coulomb were the scientist name. So here it is mentioned in big letters. Some of the SI unit prefix I have given. So this prefix can be used with the SI units only. You cannot use this separately. Here I have given the multiplier and the name of that prefix and the symbol I have given. You should use the symbol along with this basic unit. So most probably these things you might have studied in school only. Multiplier in negatives, 10 to the power of, here most probably will be using 10 to the power of minus 3, which is called milli, 10 to the power of minus 6 micro, 10 to the power of minus 9 nano, 10 to the power of minus 12 pico, 10 to the power of 15, minus 15 is femto. Similarly in positive, 10 to the power of 15 is peta, 10 to the power of 12 is tera, 10 to the power of 9 is giga, 10 power 6 is mega, 10 to the power 3 is kilo. Kilo we are using in our day-to-day life every day, kilogram and all. So then 10 to the power of 2, 10 to the power most probably we are not all using, but centimeter we are using. So these are all the prefix. The basic terms like charge, most basic quantity in an electric circuit is electric charge. Simply, if you want to define what is charge, it is the electrical property of an atomic particle of which matter consists measured in coulombs. So simply you can tell a charge is nothing but an electron which is present in the atom. So in atom there are two types of charges, one is electron and proton. So these two are the charges which we are mentioning it here. So Q suffix E which is defining some value, minus 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. C is mentioning coulomb. Coulomb is the unit of the charge. So here this Q suffix P which is equal to same value in positive. So the proton is also a charge, positive charge, which is having the value of same value in positive, this electron is having same value in negative. This is some constant value, we will be using it in the problem. If you are going for an electric circuit, you should know about this conductor and insulator, then semiconductor and all. Generally conductor, it is a substance which is having large number of free electrons. So these free electrons will be important in the conducting. So when we are applying some external energy, this conductor having free electrons, no, that free electrons will move freely through the conductor. So that movement of this electron we are telling as a electric current. So silver, copper and gold, these three are the best conductor. Since silver and copper are very costly, so we are going for copper material for a conductor. So that's why we are using copper material for conducting and all the electric equipments like coils, whatever. This copper is less expensive comparing to silver and gold. So insulator, it is a very poor conductor, or we can tell it doesn't have any quality of conducting because it doesn't have any free electron in it in room temperature. So example, you know very well, like rubber, plastic and wood materials, etc. Semiconductor, it is some little bit different kind of substance which is having like neither conductor nor insulator. So it will be working as a insulator and it will be working as a conductor on some particular conditions. This semiconductor having little few electrons also, free electrons also, and it is having insulating property also. So at particular condition it will work as a conductor. So it will be used in most electronic devices like ICs, integrated circuits, then transmitters, etc. We can see what is electric current. It is the time rate of change of charge which is measured in amperes. Which is passing through a predetermined area, we can tell. So current I is equal to Q by T. Q is the charge, T is the time which is measured in second, Q is the charge which is measured in coulomb, current is measured in amperes. We can see Coulomb's law. So we can look here, there are two charges Q1 and Q2, and the distance between this Q1 and Q2 is R. And the force between these two charges mentioned in as a force, it may be attractive force or it may be a repulsive force. So this Coulomb's law is defining the force between these two charges Q1 and Q2 is directly proportional to the product of these two charges. Directly proportional to the product of their two charges and inversely proportional to the square distance between them. So this F is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 divided by R square. It is force. So force is measured in Newton. Newton is also a scientist name, so you have to mention it in a capital letter. So mathematical expression is F is equal to K into Q1 Q2 by R square. This K is having some constant value, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. That thing you have to use it whenever you are using it in a problem. So we can see what is 1 coulomb. 1 coulomb is defined as the charge carried by 6.24 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. Or you can say like this also, if 6.24 into 10 to the power of 18 electron passes through a wire, we can say that the charge passes through the wire is 1 coulomb. We can see one problem with this. A charge of 20 nanocoulomb passes through a time interval of 2 millisecond duration. Determine the current in this circuit. So from this problem we are going to write the given data. Q is 20 nanocoulomb, the time is 2 millisecond. Then you have to calculate the current. I is equal to Q by T. Q is 20 nanocoulomb and time is 2 millisecond. You have to write the prefix. Nano means 10 to the power of minus 9, milli means 10 to the power of minus 3. So 2 will get cancelled. You will be getting 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So 10 to the power of minus 6, in the sense it is mentioned as mu here. Unit of the current is ampere. So the current passes through a time interval of 2 millisecond, duration is 10 mu ampere. We can see what is ampere. 1 ampere is the current in a circuit when 1 coulomb of charge passes through 1 second. It is mentioned in ampere. We can see one more problem. So 840 coulombs of charge passes through a imaginary plane during 2 minutes. You have to calculate the current. You should note it here. 840 coulomb is given and 2 minutes is given. You should convert this minute into second, because the unit of the time is second. If you are doing this problem with minute, you will be getting error. So you should convert this minute into second. So final I is equal to Q by T. So Q is 840 divided by time is 2 minutes. You are converting that 2 minutes into seconds. So 2 into 60, which is equal to 7 ampere. I have given the book names. You can refer these books. I will meet you in next video. Thank you.